Hello, it's Monday. For some reason, I thought my needles were today, but I listened back to a message, and it's Tuesday at 9:45. You could hear, I don't know if you could hear the wind, but the wind is howling. So I thought I would be doing another video this time of what happened when I went to the hospital. And I saw my handsome doctor, who I think looks like Michael Bublé. Just what I think. Looks like Michael Bublé. First and foremost, what I want to do is I want to thank every single one of you. You. I can keep going for over 200 and I think 22 or 21. Anyways, over 220 times doing this. Every one of you. You. Thank you. Why? Because you keep me going. You keep me going. And I'm not joking. As I've said, my life is like a fart. And some people would say a fart in a windstorm. My life is a fart in a hurricane. Absolutely. We can go fart in a tornado. Sure. No. My life is a fart in a hurricane. Category 5. It's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. So I wanted to thank every single one of you. You. For getting me through every single bloody day. I know there's people out there that gives me the thumb, that gives me the thumbs down. I could do a nasty little finger thing to you, but I'm not going to, because when I talk about depression, when I talk about things like that and people give a thumbs down, you're just cruel and nasty and just the scum of the earth. That's what I want to say to you. You're shit on somebody's shoe. That's all I want to say. Because when somebody is just pouring it out like that, I don't care if it's me. It doesn't have to be me. It could be somebody else that you're doing it to as well. And I think that's just absolutely just not even worth my time in talking. Moving on. Thunk. Anyways. For those of you who support me, thank you so much. You do not know how much it means to me to have you support me, because I do not have the physical support. Don't have it. I have my puppy who is underneath his blankets right now in his massive, huge bed that I bought him. And really, his size, he takes up one corner of this massive bed. It's one corner, and it's so funny. I'll spin it around, I'll take a picture of it, and you'll laugh. Some things, I am raw. I am raw, I am real, me's true. True is who I am. And Puddin is the nickname I was given by the 999 Army. And the 999 Army are hundreds of thousands of people. And they're awesome. And we get together and we talk about the Game of Thrones. We talk about The Walking Dead. We talk about Fear the Walking Dead. We talk about other things. I'm so happy I have them too. And all of you online have become... and I think of you as my friends, because what do friends do? And I always say that friends share and friends care and friends love. And we have that. And that's why I call you friends. somebody said once on Dan's support site, Pee Wee Tom's support site, well, you know, something about getting their head examined if people thought that online people were friends. And I came out and said, what is a friend to you? Is a friend not someone you share things with? Yes. Okay. Well, is a friend not somebody you tell things to? Yes. And is a friend not somebody they share things with? Yes. And do they share things with you? Yes. Would you not consider that a friend? Yeah. Well, then you just answered your own question. So, I consider all of you friends. I really do. Because you're kind. You're warm-hearted. I listen to you and your piano playing and your singing. Actually, it's so beautiful, your piano playing. It really is. And I go to Angie's channel and I listen to Angie's. And I go to a number of yours. And I listen and watch. If you have stuff on your channel, I do go. And I will subscribe. 'Cause I'm interested. Truly interested. So, thank you. For being there for me. Thank you. I appreciate every single thing that you do. Every single thing that you say. And supporting me to the nth degree that you do. So, all my love for Mr. P, who's sleeping right now. Because I've been up all night, literally. I haven't slept at all right now. And I'm probably going to sleep. He's going to crawl in underneath me and we're going to have a snooze. So thank you so much. And I'm going to do a video right now. I'm going to show you the experimental farm. It's a farm where they keep the cattle in the wintertime in the barns. And this is right in the middle of the city. So we are so fortunate to have a farm in the middle of the city. Where they do so much. They do testing with plants and everything. So I live literally a 3-minute drive from the experimental farm. So I'm going to include that so you can see that. And I wanted to get that out there because somebody had asked me about and talked about depression, and I wanted to address that because they had responded to what I had said. However, they didn't respond to me on my site, on my stream. They responded to me on theirs. So I know that she's going to see it on my stream. Anyways, enough said. I hope everybody has a beautiful Monday. And it's tomorrow. I get the needles in the head by my neurologist. And I can't wait. So peace, love, always love. Mish out. Manum, manum, and that's my way. So there he is in his bed. His new bed. See, that's, it's so big I can't get. There it is. It's so big. For such a tiny puppy. He's trying to make his bed now. He's trying to hide underneath his sheets. Or is his blanket. And behind him, that's a pillow that's bigger than he is. Seriously, it's bigger than he is. He has his ball. But that's his bed. It's soft and fluffy.
He likes it. He brings his other blanket in there, his velour pillow. Or, sorry, his velour blanket. And now he has this new velour blanket in there, his blue one. So that's what Mommy bought him. So he loves that. Hey, Ba? Hey, Ba? You like your blanket, eh, Ba? You like your new bed? Yes, cozy, hey? It's nice and cozy. Hey, Ba? See? I love you. I love you, Boo. I love you.
It's Sunday. Hobby Sunday. We're going to cut all that out. Hobby Sunday. And we are in a weather advisory. It's not a watch. We're in it. We're looking at minus 27 and 35 centimeters of snow. So, it actually is blown by real quickly that I can see because I opened up my curtains. Church came by and we had a long talk about a lot of different things happening. Everything from A to Z, pretty much. For the orthopedic surgeon, and I'm telling you, he reminds me, I couldn't figure it out before, but he seriously reminds me of Michael Bublé. Mm-hmm. Michael Bublé. Not joking. And so when I told him that, he started to chuckle. He said, is that a good thing? And he comes from the same area as Louisiana is Michael Bublé's wife. And he said, yes, he stole her. How he said it. Yes, he stole her. And I started to laugh because I thought that was so cute. I go to see him again in 2 months' time. And then again, I go and see about this wandering finger of mine, wandering little pinky. And he's going to take x-rays and we're going to go from there. And who knows? I may have to have surgery on my hand. And that would be, you know what? That would be fine with me. That surgery, I can deal with. Because then I wouldn't have people continually asking me, why is your pinky out? Why do you do this when you're drinking? Like, this is what happens when I'm drinking. This is what happens. It doesn't bend down. And it doesn't go in. Like, there's a marked difference when I'm holding something like that. See, there we go. There's... And if you can hear that, it makes great noises.
So, I'm here again. And just waiting for the orthopedic surgeon. Since there was a severe bus, an OC transport bus crash, and most of the patients got taken here. And a lot of the patients had orthopedic injuries. So there was legs amputated and things like that. So I would suspect that they're pretty busy here over these last few days. So I'm prepared to wait for a while. No problem. Oh, anyways, what I was saying, what Dr. Rostock, who was here in this building, actually one floor up. They're going to get the report that's done and that's needed. Like I said, because he knew Dr. Malou, Malou is on part of the other surgical, colorectal surgical team. And working with Dr. Friedlich, I have no idea why they don't talk, why they didn't. And so a report was sent in May. Everybody seems to have the report except for Dr. Friedlich. Dun, dun, dun. So Megan is going to do her very best at talking to Dr. Rostam on Wednesday when she sees him and get this off as soon as possible to let them know that this is definitely a colorectal issue for Dr. Friedlich and that they need to do a colostomy. That's the one with the bag that's attached. They take your colon out. Then they have a bit of your colon and they pull it through. And they pull it through a hole in your stomach that they make. And there you go. That's a stoma. Beautiful, bright, sunshiny day. I gotta be funny.
I gotta be me. I gotta be me.
Yeah, I'm in a funny mood today. That happens. After the day I had yesterday, you'd understand. Anyways, I'll put this down so people don't get freaked out. Agriculture. So that's where they do different stuff, either with livestock or just, you know, agriculture. There's seed flowers and stuff. So there's all the agriculture. Plants. It's very cool. And there's the barns and other buildings. And there we go. Those are big, 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 big barns. As I'm turning, you're going to see big barns. There we go. And that's where the livestock is. And it's just so beautiful in the summertime. See, that's more buildings for the upkeep for livestock. And I'm freezing, so. So it is freezing in here. Trucks, big ass trucks and wide loads. And that's where they keep the animals. The animals are housed. All in, and this is the farm. So experimental farm is massive. It goes on and on and on and on and on. And this is all in the middle of the city, is this open farmland.
We're gonna try this again.
Step by step, I can see it in your eyes, cause they never tell me lies. I can feel that body shake and the heat between your legs. You've been scared of love and what it did to you. You don't have to run, I know what you've been through. Just a simple touch and it can set you free. We don't have to rush when you're alone with me.
Downward dog. Is it still on? It's still on. Hello. Why, hello. Downward dog. Awesome. Downward dog. Cobra.
DJ, we're gonna go for a little funky walk. Pick your feet up, pick your knees up, take yourself for a little funky walk around your space. Yeah, I don't know about you, but my head moves when I'm funky. Put your head in it, now put your arms in it. How many different funky ways can you walk? Yeah, baby. And a one, two, three. It's a one, two, and a one, two, three. Now this little
You got it, baby. You got my butt.